So we're here for ISC 2022 in Barcelona, in beautiful industrial acrol studio. I'm with Brian Allen, Executive VP of Illuminarium Experiences, and Joe Connover, Senior Manager at Panasonic Connect. I'm François Villaret, Head of Business Development at HOLOPLOT. Thank you for being here. So Brian, like since Atlanta and Vegas, what has been the journey so far for you?
Wow, it's been a journey for sure. We were looking to design a truly immersive space, something that hadn't been done before. And I remembered the demo in New York and we connected again. So we set off designing an immersive sound system that the world had never seen.
When I think about your journey from Atlanta to Las Vegas, I think for all the technology partners, each individually, but together, symbiotically, to help your vision.
Yeah.
You know, I look back at Atlanta and see it as kind of a hybrid solution.
Yeah.
And then coming into Las Vegas, I kind of see it as, not speaking for you, but kind of the fully realized version, at least on our technology side.
Yeah.
I know all the technology partners work to create those efficiencies learned from Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
And I love to see that now in the opening of Las Vegas, to see everyone kind of fully realized and really lock in step with you there. Yeah. And you can kind of feel that.
Yeah, it was very much an off-Broadway, but we knew that partners like yourselves were fully committed to the vision, to the roadmap, to the future, which is why we chose people like you. I don't think it's about having all the answers. So coming away from the meeting in Berlin and the meetings I've had with you and your team, we're always asking questions and we're always trying to figure out how to improve upon the product or the experience. And it really comes away, it boils down to the guest experience. We're trying to achieve something where guests come away asking questions with an emotional reaction or something they've never seen before.
Yeah, and this, like, again, the Atlanta show, typically the very first opening show for us, it felt like as a step, as an accomplishment, but not as an end. Like, we all felt all across the technology partner as, okay, that's the first standout we make to the market, we step, but we're gonna, of course, go way beyond that. And that's this continuous journey that also, like, completely excites the entire team, like, as you were just saying, you call us, you have potentially an issue or something that you haven't solved yet, you call us, you involve us, and then we work together on making and improving the experience.
That is one of the most exciting things, I think, speaking for myself, is to hear from our, clients like yourself, partner, I should say. We are shoulder to shoulder in this, so we learn so much. And it's very interesting to see, since that, as immersive experiences have grown, especially accelerated post-pandemic, and what we've learned, to see all the creatives coming out and all these new experiences, and it's very interesting.
I think the future of immersive entertainment is expanding across more verticals than just entertainment. Mm-hmm. I think immersive is gonna make its way into every aspect of our lives. And I don't mean that in like a Minority Report Terminator style, but I think it's really gonna help us. Everything is becoming immersive in its own right. I think education has the biggest way to grow in that regard. I think the learning experience can be so vastly improved by the use of a venue like Illuminarium or an immersive thought process. Mm-hmm. We all read from textbooks. We read in a book, this is what, the ancient civilizations looked like and this is what they did. And imagine stepping into Roman ruins or stepping into an ancient Aztec civilization and being transported there.
So Brian, Joe, what do you think the future holds for us as, as a group, as technology partners?
We have challenges in bending light, and that's kind of what we do at our lensing. You have created, overcome challenges in bending sound and waves. So it's interesting, and I think for that, it leads us to a place that could be fully flexible and customizable for those spaces.
Mm-hmm.
For me, I think having some interactivity is key to the content. So Ken, I walk into these spaces, can I have a personal journey, like you said? But that on my side, I think, is the next thing. So how can I truly be a part of this mm-hmm. space instead of just a walkthrough? How do I curate those experiences? How do I make that truly interactive? How do I entertain for the future, mm-hmm. be it in music, be it in the visual, mm-hmm. you know, stimulus? It's very interesting, but I think what we have, this truly unique technology that can be honed, you know, is offers, say it's a, you know, it offers a palette for the artist, mm-hmm. you know, so we're creating a new palette for them to paint on, which you have done so well.
Thank you. Right, so we have this technology today that allows us to create things like Illuminariums, but in my mind, the technology is always evolving. You're always going to be chasing it. It's always going to be something new. And to me, it's just a tool, right? So we're always going to need entertainment. We're always going to want entertainment. And immersive, it seems to be the direction that people want to go. They're craving that personalization, that journey. And the technology is going to follow that. So it's just like using the right tool for the right job at that point.
I also think it's our job on the technology side to enhance the communication between. We're very siloed, you know, you're Sonic, you know, we're here, we're this. But in the past, it was very much a race for this desperate and competing systems. So most people historically spent a lot of time and resources just fighting those systems to, you know, I'm gonna buy this thing off the shelf and I'm gonna spend years to make it communicate and try to create that. So I think it's our job, you know, on the technology partner side to share those communications, to be able to afford people, you know, like Brian, the ability to do that and not have to spend those resources just to get two things to speak to each other, you know? Mm-hmm. You know, like HOLOPLOT that we probably wouldn't have done 5 years ago, mm-hmm. right?
It's also about like involving the creatives right throughout the entire process, making yes. sure we, you know, listen to their needs and also develop and adapt the technology according to these needs in order to achieve their creative purpose and aim overall. Mm-hmm. So it's I think it's also part of, you know, what the future holds for us. It's about incorporating the creatives and making sure that the different technology partners are, you know, supporting this creative vision.